It's time for the Family Feud. Introducing the Speek family. Amy, Bill, Mike, Jim, and Frank. Playing against our returning champions, the Myles family. Ryan, Claudia, Earl, Sakina, and Jason. You're about to see these two families battle it out for $20,000 in cash. Because it's time.
Welcome to the Family Feud. Yeah! Our returning champs, the Myles family, playing against the Speek family. Come on, let's play the Family Feud. Ryan, Amy.
How are you doing?
Good luck. We surveyed 100 people, top six answers on the board. Give me the most popular answer. Name something the pet psychic might say your dog wants more of. Amy.
Treats.
He wants treats.
Yep. Yes.
I can tell you they all want more treats.
That's right.
Treats. And I'm not even psychic. But Brian.
Attention.
Yes. Attention. Clap it. Okay, they're going to play.
Yes, nice baby.
Yeah, oh, yes. Oh, yes.
Second day, you're back.
Yes.
Introduce me again to your family.
I sure will, Richard. This is my beautiful mother, Claudia, my father, Earl, my lovely wife, Sakina, and my brother, Jason.
All right. Yay! Good job.
Yeah.
All right. Hey, come on. So any more businesses you've added? Let's see, you got the cutting hair.
Yeah, the barbershop.
We have
the fitness center for women.
Did you like that movie, The Barbershop?
The Barbershop was excellent.
Was that funny?
Excellent.
They're making the sequel.
Filming at my show.
Filming at your job, Claudia.
Hi, you look
How
wonderful.
Are you? Thank you. So do you.
Thank you.
So anything different?
Nothing's different.
Nothing different today?
Same thing.
Same stuff? Like the pin.
Thank you.
Name something the pet psychic might say to your that your dog wants more of.
He wants more exercise.
All right. That's right. Give me more exercise.
Yeah!
Norwalks.
Richard.
Earl.
Yes, sir.
How are you?
Just fine, thank you.
Good to see you again.
Thank you very much.
So, a pet psychic. You know, the great thing about being a pet psychic is the dog's not going to tell you you're wrong. No. This is not what I want. Unless it's Scooby. Okay, well, name something a pet psychic might want or might say your dog wants more of.
How about more dogs? More brothers and sisters?
I want more dogs. Okay. He wants more dogs.
Sakina.
Do we ever find out what you do?
No.
What do you do?
I'm a self-employed childcare provider.
Childcare provider.
Yes.
All right.
Yes.
How many kids?
I'm 14.
14?
Yes.
Holy smokes, that's a lot of kids to keep track of. Man, I can barely keep track of one. Well, name something the pet psychic might say your dog wants more of.
I would have to say sex.
Okay.
Good answer.
You know, these are sounding a lot of the things I want. I want more attention, more sex. Jason,
how you doing?
So what do you do?
I'm a mortgage broker.
A mortgage broker?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Good business. Good time to be a mortgage broker right now.
Perfect time. Interest rates are really low.
What are they?
They're about at least 5.5 or
30. Oh, I can't believe you said that. We can do better, though, right?
Yes, sir.
Well, name something the pet psychic might want say your dog wants more of.
How about more baths?
Yes! Yes! Yes!
Yes! Got to be up there.
I'm leaning towards less, but more baths.
No, even more baths.
Okay, Brian. It's only one strike. Something the pet psychic might say your dog wants more of. 3 seconds.
Friends.
Stop there.
Snacks?
It's up there. Okay, okay. Psychic friends. That's he wants more. They're up there. All right, Claudia. Get ready.
Let's go, Mom.
He wants more flea medication.
That's okay. Good. Flea
Yes. Yes.
That's it.
Okay. If it's up there, you've swept the board. Yes. If not, speak. Flea medication. Amy. You guys have a lot of time to think about this.
More space.
More space. Yeah. He wants more space. That's right. Okay, if it's up there, you've stolen the points and first blood. Give me more space. Claudia. Bill.
How are you?
Okay. Top four answers on the board this time. Name a wealthy family in American history. Bill.
Rockefellers.
The Rockefellers. Gonna play or pass?
We'll pass.
Oh, they're passing that on to you. Okay.
You know it.
American history. Yes. It scares some people. Earl, a wealthy family in American history.
The Cartiers.
The Cartiers.
Yes.
That's right. They got stores in all the malls.
Yeah.
The Cartiers.
Oh. Wow. Come on, come
on. Something better than that, Sakina.
Okay, I'm going to have to say the Gates.
The Gates. In recent American history. Okay.
All right.
Oh, Bill Gates.
Oh. Come on, Dave.
Good answer, good answer.
A wealthy family in American history.
How about the Fords?
Yes, go ahead. Yeah.
The Fords. The Fords. All right. If it's up there, you guys are still alive. If not, the Speak family's over there huddling. The Fords. Okay.
Come on.
All right.
All right. Here wealthy families. They need to spend more time on advertising.
The Vanderbilts.
The Vanderbilts.
Good answer. Good
All
answer.
Right.
Good answer.
That's right. And they're not just something that went on a Ford. Okay, if it's up there, you guys have stolen the points. The Vanderbilts. What's number two?
Kennedy.
The Kennedys. And number four?
The Hearst.
Hearst. They've got all sorts of stuff. Hearst Castle. The score at the end of round one. The Speak family, 151. Myles. I've got miles to go, but we'll be back with round two. Right after this. Don't go away. Come on back. More interesting trivia right here on The Feud. Welcome back to the Family Feud. The Speak family, 151. The Myles family, yet to score. Amy.
Hi.
Welcome.
Thank you.
Where are you guys from?
We're from Chicago.
Chicago, the Windy City, Chi-Town.
Yep.
Okay. Where?
Go Bears.
They need all the help they can get.
Introduce me to your family.
Well, this is my husband, Bill, my brother-in-law, Mike, my sister-in-law, Jen, and my other brother-in-law, Frank.
All right. Got all the in-laws here.
I do.
Okay. Well, Earl and Mike, let's play the Feud. Surveyed 100 people, top five answers on the board. Name something you remember being punished for in school. Mike.
Talking in class.
Talking in class. Number one answer. You can play?
We're going to play.
Okay, Earl, they're going to play. They're playing. Jen, you're going to play.
I'm going to play.
So what do you do?
I'm a stay-at-home mom. Yeah. Three boys.
Three boys?
Three boys.
And what
been
ages?
Married, 9, 8, and 5. So
I got there's a lot of stuff going on there.
Right.
You must have like 15 hours of homework every night.
Yeah, it gets a little tough sometimes.
Oh, I would think so. Well, what do you think? Something you remember being punished for, or your kids in school?
Not turning their homework in.
Turning homework in.
That's right.
How are you doing?
What do you do?
I am a salesman for a big family fence company that we have in Chicago.
A fence family?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
All right.
So,
just like that. Okay. Well, do you remember being punished for school for something?
Cheating.
Cheating. Cheating, it's not just in school anymore. Okay, Amy.
Bad grades.
Bad grades. You see?
Come on, Bill.
Fighting.
Good answer.
Fighting.
Show me fighting. Yes.
That's it. That's right, Mike. It's always the guys that know this, right?
Spitwads.
Good answer. Good answer. Good answer. Good answer.
That's right. Just the perfect amount of spit and wad.
Spit wads. Get ready.
The Myles family's
come
over
on,
there.
Jen, come on,
hey.
Come on.
Jen.
Not that I did this.
No, no. We're not holding you
but
responsible.
But smoking in the bathroom.
Okay.
If it's up there, you're still alive. Smoking in the bathroom.
Good one. Brian.
We got it, Brian.
Brian, you got it?
We got it.
You do?
We got it.
Okay, give it to me.
Being late.
That's it. Being late.
You can smoke in the bathroom all you want, just
don't
be late. Okay, if it's up there, you've stolen those points away from the Speak family. Being late. What's number five?
Cutting class.
The Speak family, a commanding lead at 214 points. The Myles family have got to hurry up. But when we come back, we're going to triple the points to find out who's going to play fast money and a chance at $20,000. Don't skip class. Don't skip the next show. Welcome back to the Feud. The Speak family, 214. The Myles family, I've got to hurry up. Sakina, Jen. All right. Good luck. Who's ever in the lead at the end of this question goes on to play fast money and a chance for $20,000. But you only got one shot at it, one strike. Make your answers count. Point values are tripled. Top four answers on the board. For what specific reason did you get your last traffic ticket? Skinner.
Speeding.
Speeding.
We're
going to
play.
Okay. They're going to play. Jason, your family is all in your hands.
Okay, I'm going to have to. Can you repeat the question?
Specific reason you got your last traffic ticket.
Let's see. For throwing something out the window.
For littering. Okay. I got to warn you here, though. If it's up there, you're still alive. If it's not up there, there's not enough points in the bank to beat the Speak family. Littering! Show me number two.
Parking.
A parking ticket. Number three.
Red,
red light. And number four. You tried, though.
We did.
You got it. You got it. Got it. Thank you. Ready? Who's going to play?
All right, Bill. Come on over here and chat.
When we come back, we're going to play Fast Money and a chance for $20,000. Welcome Welcome back to the Feud. The Speak family won the game, and it's time to play Fast Money and a chance for $20,000. Okay. Bill is off stage where he can't see or hear your answers. I'm going to ask you 5 questions in 20 seconds. Try to give me the most popular answer. If you can't think of something, say pass. We'll come back to it if there's time left. Now, if you and Bill together get 200 points, you win $20,000. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
20 seconds on the clock, please. Clock will start after I read the first question. Name something you need to play Pin the Tail on the Donkey.
A donkey.
Name an occupation where you might work all night.
Cashier.
Name a fruit you have to cut open to eat.
A watermelon.
Name something people put in a safety deposit box.
Money.
Name something that might be needed to be tightened.
Your shoelaces.
Good job, Ken.
Okay, let's see how you did. Name something you need to play Pin the Tail on a Donkey. You said, a donkey. You need a donkey. Survey said, 11. A real donkey might kick. Name an occupation where you might work all night. You said, cashier. Survey said, 7. It's okay, you're on the board. Name a fruit you have to cut open to eat. You said, watermelon. Good answer. Survey said, 31. That's more like it. Okay. Name something people put in a safety deposit box. You said, money. They're not putting it in the stock market. Survey said, 17. Okay. Name something that might need to be tightened. You said, shoelaces. Survey said, 17. 83 points. Good job. Clear the board. We will bring out her brother-in-law. She got you 83 points. That means you need 117.
Great.
I'll ask you the same 5 questions. You can't duplicate the answers. If you do, you'll hear this sound. I'll say try again. Give me another answer. It's tougher. So we're going to give you 25 seconds. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Remind everybody of Jen's answers. 25 seconds on the clock. Time will start after I read the first question. Name something you need to play Pin the Tail on the Donkey.
Tail.
Name an occupation where you might work all night.
Doctor.
Name a fruit you have to cut open to eat.
Orange.
Name something people put in a safety deposit box.
Money. Jewelry.
Name something that might need to be tightened.
Shoelaces.
Try again.
Belt.
Tighten your belt. Okay. Let's see how you did. You need 117 points. Name something you need to play Pin the Tail on the Donkey. You said, tail, she said, donkey. You need both of those. It's Pin the Tail on the Donkey. Survey said, 19. Blindfold. Blindfold, number one answer. Name an occupation where you might work all night. You said, doctor, all night. Survey said, 6. Security guard. Security guard up all night. Name a fruit that you have to cut open to eat. You said, orange, survey said, 18. Good job. Watermelon was the number one answer. But orange looks like it was right up there. You need 74 points. Name something people put in a safety deposit box. You said, jewelry. Survey said, yeah, that's more like it. 38 points. You need 38 points. Something that might need to be tightened. You said, the belt. Tighten the belt, I'm on a diet. You need 38 points. Survey said. Oh. Screw. Screw on a bolt. Tighten that up. But we're gonna give them $5 a point for a total of $915. And they get to come back tomorrow for another chance against another family for $20,000. Come on back and see us right here on the Family Feud.